Why did the home teacher cross the road? What?
I don't know.
Because it was the last day of the month.
Oh!
So, okay, so if you haven't heard, in this last general conference, President Nelson like gets up there and on the stand, and he gets rid of home teaching and visiting teaching.
We have made the decision to retire home teaching and visiting teaching as we have known them.
What were your guys' like first initial reaction when that happened?
I was just like, sweet. That's great.
The way he said it at first, like no one knew anything else was coming. We thought he was just getting rid of it. And I was like, oh, okay.
I was just like, about time.
I think a lot of people just weren't affected because they didn't do it anyways, which is unfortunate, but kind of true.
It was probably like a small weight lifted because they don't have that guilt anymore from not doing it.
But that's the reason I say about time was because I just didn't think it was an effective organization. I just didn't think it applied very well to our time.
I mean, I think it had its heyday. Yeah. Like, it was a revealed program.
It's heyday.
Yeah.
What is that?
When a hay day?
It's like
that's not a thing.
When you're baling hay, like the day where you bale all the hay, that's when you're gonna get all the money.
Okay, sorry, I'm not from a farm. Like, I don't know what that's all about. Okay, sorry. Keep going.
I'm sorry, I am from a farm.
Okay. Sorry. Maybe it's an Oregon child.
But home teaching, it had its time. You know, it's like Superman in Justice League. Like he had his time, and then he died.
And you should have stayed. I haven't watched that one yet, David!
So home teaching, originally, it was a program by the church, which just invited members to, they were given assignments to visit other members in the ward. And that way, like, everyone had a person to watch over them, to make sure that they're taken care of. And it's honestly a great concept because the Savior has taught us to love our neighbors.
Right.
The thing that I wasn't a big fan of it is that it was very like you had a list and your priesthood leader would call you or whatever and text you and be like, did you visit those people? Mm-hmm. And it would just every day it was just like, so have you done your home teaching? Have you visited your people?
And you're supposed to do it once a month.
Right.
So that's why I made the joke about like it was the last day of the month. So he crossed the street.
Because you've got to satisfy the requirement. You know, you've got to fulfill the expectation.
Check
it off the list. And that's not, the Savior doesn't work like that. People aren't numbers. You know, it's not about, oh, did I check this off? The point of home teaching was to care about people. Mm-hmm. And I think that was getting a little lost because the church kind of started doing this thing where it's like, oh, well, I texted him, so I did my home teaching. Or like,
yeah.
And then like thing you said, Elder Holland, you know.
Yeah, Elder Holland quoted a bumper sticker that said, if I honk, you've been home taught.
Right, and that's just not the point, you know.
Right.
It's like, it's not about getting it checked off a list so my priesthood leader will stop getting mad at me or so I have 100%, I'm a good Mormon.
You could have a pizza party.
Right, you could be 100% home teacher, but not actually know anything about the people.
Right, and it's so true. And so that's our opinion on why President Nelson went in, got rid of that program, and introduced ministering instead.
Instead, we will implement a newer, holier approach to caring and ministering to others. We will refer to these efforts simply as ministering.
And essentially what ministering is, it's a very similar concept. I mean, it's the same motivation as to why we had home and visiting teaching, but now you still receive assignments because we want to make sure that everyone in the ward is being accounted for. But there's not a deadline. There's not a specific thing you need to do. You don't need to go into their home and teach a lesson like was the case with home and visiting teaching. It's just a lot more laid back, and you can... I feel like in my case, I've been able to develop actual friendships with the people, and it's not like an assignment that I need to do.
It was interesting because every month the church would publish it was called the First Presidency Message that was meant to be used when you're home or visiting teaching. And that's gone now. Like, they don't do that because they want us to just care about people.
And personally, as a member of the church, receiving home teachers was always actually an uncomfortable thing for me because I had read the message. I knew what it was, and then these two people would come over to my house, they'd sit down, And my parents would, like, all as a kid, you know, we'd all come in, we'd sit down, and the home teacher would just be like, okay, here's the message. But we all knew what the message was.
Because you had already read it.
Yeah. And so then it was just, like, this kind of weird, like, ritual. And I was just like, I know what they're going to say. And they'd say it. And we'd be like, okay. And they'd be like, okay, we're done. Bye. And they'd leave.
And that was it.
And it was just weird. So ministering has, it's only been a few months, and I've loved it.
Me too.
Like, the people who have ministered to me, they just came over and like, hey, we made you an apple pie. We were just thinking about you. How is it going? And I felt so great. But it was just like such a kind thing. And I get that that's people did that in home teaching. But now it's just like I felt more like they weren't doing it because they had to get this done.
It's just more genuine now.
I felt like they were just like doing their day and like, oh, we should. I don't know. And then my home ministering.
We still don't know what to call them.
So the people we minister, it was just really fun because we were like, hey, let's go get shaved ice. And we just talked.
And that counts.
And we had such a good time. Yeah. And I got to know them. And we were just talking about like what's going on in our lives and like dating and school. And I felt so much closer to them. And I've been a member of the church my whole life. I've gone home teaching. Mm-hmm. And I felt closer with these friends than I have a lot of people I've home taught.
And I think that's the point. Like, we're not looking for what counts. A lot of people, when they took away home teaching, were like, oh my gosh, what's this new program that's coming in? Well, it's not really a new program at all. It's just basically...
It's the same program.
Yeah, well, it's not a program. It's just being friends with people. Like, just be a genuine friend to these people. Yeah. And that's it. Like, I think there's great value in... not oversimplifying what ministering is. Mm-hmm. It's just being friends how Christ would want us to be friends with people.
Yeah.
And that's it. And that's all it needs to be. Yeah. It doesn't need to be anything more than that. It's just loving people.
Well, there's a specifically quoted, as church members minister, they prayerfully seek to serve as he would to, quote, comfort those that stand in need of comfort, end quote. Quote, watch over the church always and be with and strengthen them. End quote. Quote, visit the house of each member, end quote, and help become a true disciple of Jesus Christ.
Just like when Christ taught, he introduced the higher law. And it's not like the people were necessarily doing, like, really, like, they were trying the best that they thought was right. You know what I mean? Like,
right, well, it's like they were doing good.
They were doing good, but...
Needed very specific instructions to achieve that.
There are commandments, and there's culture, and there's traditions, and what had happened in before Christ's time was a lot of culture and traditions had sunk in and basically infiltrated what the commandments were. And so they'd take a commandment, and then they'd make, through tradition and culture, 10 more commandments to make sure they keep that commandment, which led to a lot of confusion about the law of Moses, and essentially... We're kind of doing the same thing with home teaching. We're simplifying. Mm-hmm. We're removing the reports, and we're just going back to the basics. Like Christ said, like you were talking about, the higher law, love one another as Jesus loves us.
Yeah.
So let us know your thoughts on ministering and your thoughts on home teaching, the thoughts on the change or lack of change in the comment section. And make sure to subscribe to all of our social media channels, and we'll see you there, and send us messages and emails, and you're cool.
Thanks for watching.
No more ministry. Wait, oh, dang it. I'm Justin Scissorhands, and I'm cutting out home teaching, and we only have ministering.
Moving my hair away from you.
This makes my jugulars uncomfortable.
Oh, <whoa. laughs> It didn't work out as I planned. I was hoping that it would fit in my sleeves.